done. Okay, so this is a generative shading, right? So I'll click the okay. So all the surfacing main commands what we require for BRW product design, we'll see. So there are toolbars, that is surfaces, wireframe, operations, transformation features, then this join and healing, okay, sketcher. So these are the main toolbars you can see, surfaces, wireframe, operations, and transformation features. Okay. Also, this is join and healing, all the commands. So we'll see what are the uses of one by one, what are the commands uses, okay? So we'll see one by one. So first, before starting the surfacing, you have to add the geometric set because we are not working in part body. What are the solid things we are doing in the part body only? But for surfacing, we are using the this generative geometric set. So whatever will the operations we will do into the geometric set only. Okay, so I will insert the geometric set first. So whatever will the surfacing things, point, line, planes, all the surfacing commands comes under the geometric set only. Okay. So whenever you go for surfacing design, any like product design, like plastic product or either it is BRW product, it will comes under the geometric set. And then finally, we will convert the surfacing thing into the solid. Okay. So we'll see one by one how we are doing this process. So I will select one plane. I will shift into the sketcher. Yeah. And then I will draw like this random shape. Exit the workbench. Okay. So this is my curve. Okay. This is my curve. And from this curve, I want to make a surface. Okay. So for that, I am using the command in surfaces. The first command is your extrude command. Okay. So I'm selecting the extrude command. So it is asking the profile, which profile you want to make the surface from, which profile. Okay, so I'm selecting this profile. Okay. And it's asking the direction. Okay. So we can make the surface in the two directions here only. Okay. So first is your Y direction and second is your Z direction, because an X direction itself, a curve direction is X. So we cannot make in the X direction, we can make in the Y and Z. Okay, so you can right click here and you can select the axis. So I am selecting the Y axis. So Y is this axis. Then dimension it is asking. So we can put your dimension, whatever the length of your surface. Okay. Okay, and here also the second limit. Second limit means what? Like first limit is, this is the first limit, right? And second limit is like in this direction. Okay. So if you want some other dimension here, okay, something like 70 mm. Okay, so you can able to add the surface in second direction of the curve also. So this is my first direction, one. Okay, this is 50 mm. This is my second direction, that is 70 mm. Okay. And if you want to make the similar dimension at both sides, you can use the mirror extent. So here, if you put the 50 on second side, it will automatically update the 50. Whatever will be the dimension you put in second direction, limit second, the same length will be there. It will add, okay, along the curve. Okay. So here also you can change your direction in the Z also, like this. Okay. With the help of same curve, can add your direction in the Z and either your Y. Okay. If you select the X axis, it will show the error because the profile is parallel to the direction. That's why. Okay. So only two direction we can make. So like this, you can add the surface. You can make the surface using the extrude command. Okay. So this is extrude command. Any line, any curve, if you have, you can make the surface using that curve and you can add the dimension. Okay. Hope this is clear. Okay. Yeah.
Sir. We'll not give, we're not able to give thickness, sir, there.
Yeah, thickness that I'm, I will show you how we are making solid part using the surface. Okay. There is a direct command of thickness, but we are not preferring that. Okay. We are doing our all the things, closed bodies in the surface only. Okay. And then we are making them a solid. Okay. So say like we have some 10 mm thickness part. Okay. From this surface, I want to make the 10 mm closed body. So what I will do, I will offset this surface first into the 10 mm, okay, in the direction of 10, in the dimension of 10 mm in the z direction, okay. So I will select the next command, that is offset command, okay. Here it is showing that surface, which surface you want to be offsetted. So I will select this. It is asking the direction, you can offset value you can put, so like 10 mm I want to offset, okay. If I click on the preview, you can see the surface is created, okay. If you reverse the direction, it will go into the bottom side. If you reverse the direction, it will go into the upside, okay. That which side, this is my stable surface, okay. From stable surface, at which direction you want, you can select. So bottom, yes, you can ask the question.
Yeah, fine.
So like this, you can select like which direction. Okay, so say like I want in this direction only. So I'll click OK. So this offsetted surface is formed, right? So now my task is I want to fill the complete things. Just a minute. Hello.
Yes.
Sorry. So see, like we want to fill the four sides. Okay. So this side I want to, this and this, between this curve and this curve, I want to make the surface. Okay. So how can I make? I have three or four options. One is fill. Second is your blend command. I will use either. I will use the multi-section command. Okay. So in this condition, this is my first curve, this is my second curve. For fill, if you want to run the fill command, in that condition, you want either three or four curves, which has to be closed, okay? So this is open-ended two curves. This is this curve and this curve. These two has doesn't have a relation, okay? So we want to make one relation, means like we want to close from these two ends. This point and this point, I want to make one line, and from these end points, like this point, and this point, I want to one make one line, okay? Then we can have one close four curves, okay? And by that, using that, I will run my fill command, okay? So how can I close these two ends? I will use the line command, and then point to point, means this point one and this point two. I'll select okay. Okay, again, what I will do, I will use this point one and this point. Okay, so now you can see I have four curves, this one, and this one, okay? So now I am able to make my fill command, okay? So I will use the fill command, and I'll select the four curves in the sequence, okay? Not in like this one and then this one. You have to select in the sequence, like this one, and this one. Either this one, and this one. Now, so the sequence is very important. If you select the in the sequence, then only the surface will be filled. So I'm selecting this first one, this second one, this third, and this is fourth. Okay, so this close counter will come. So close counter means it is ready to fill. So you can click the OK. So you can see surface is created between that two surfaces. Okay. So
yes,
you can use the fill command for filling the gaps. Okay, next command is your blend command, also you can use. So if you have a two, this line from this side, I want to make a surface. So what I will do, I will use the two curves, like this one and this one, these two curves I have. Okay, so there is no relation between these two curves. Okay, so like this line is there, but if I want to go with the fill command, so I want, again, I want to make line here, but I am not using fill command, I'm using the blend command. Okay, that condition you can directly blend command also. You can select the blend command. Here is the blend command. You can directly select the blend command. So it is asking the first curve, so you can select the first curve. Okay, again, it is asking the second curve, you can select the second curve. Don't select the supports. Okay, if you want to make a flat surface, you don't need to select the supports. Okay, So direction is very important. Both the direction will be in the same direction, arrow direction. Then if you preview, you can see your surfaces will be created. Okay, what if you select the first support, then, and if you select second support, this, so the surface will change like this, right? So this is okay. Like, yeah, so if you want flat surface, you can clear the selection. You don't need supports, you will get the flat surface. Okay, so this is also one thing you can do for filling the gaps. Okay, so this is also one of the command. And yeah, from here also, from this side, you can directly offset your this thing also. So you need just dimension, like what will the dimension, that is 140 mm. Okay, so I will offset this surface into the 140 mm. Okay, so I will use the offset command, this direction. Okay, that is 140 mm. Okay, and see the surface is offsetted at 140 mm. Okay, in this place, this side is okay. So now the third option we are using is your multi-section. So multi-section also we can use to fill this type of gaps. Okay, so for multi-section we require two lines. Between two lines we directly connect also within the multi-section, and also we have two guides, like these guides and these guides. So using the two lines and two guide curves, you can make the surface using the multi-section. Okay, so I am using the multi-section. This is the multi-section command, multi-section. Okay, so what I will do, yes. I will select the first curve, that is upper curve. I will select the second curve, this is bottom curve. So you can see the direction in the same direction will be the same, and second is your guides. So guide, select this one guide first, and this is second guide. Okay, this direction will be in the same direction, that is requirement, and guide, two guides I am giving. So you can see the surface is created. Okay, so there are three ways. Also there are more ways. Okay, these are three ways we are mainly using to closing the surfaces in the making the closed body. Okay, so this is not closed head. Okay, we have made just a surfaces. So how can we make one complete join using this all of the surfaces? So that for that we are using the join command. Okay, so in operation the first command, join command. So I will join all the surface. These are all the separate surface, right? This extrude is separate, yes. Offset, separate, field, blend, offset, multi-screen, all the surfaces separate. So I want one complete body. So in that, I will use the join command. You can select from tree directly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. And the merging distance will be 1 micron. That is fine. So 1 micron will be the fine. So just click OK. So you can see all the commands are get added and your join one is only on, right? So how can you check if this body is closed or not? How can you check if there is a gap or not? Okay, so how can you check? For that checking purpose, you can use the boundary command. Here is the boundary command.
Okay.
You select the boundary, and if you select on this body, it will show the error. The selected body is closed. It has no boundary. Means your body is closed. Okay, so if this... Yeah. Error is not showing means your body is somewhere open. Okay, so it is showing that body is closed, means that is fine. Okay, it has no boundary. Okay, so it is to, it is ready to make the solid body using the surface. Like this is closed, this is closed, this is closed only in a surfacing. How can you check? You can cut the dynamic sectioning. In the dynamic sectioning, there is a sectioning command. So I'll right click here. Okay. I'll right click here and I'll on the dynamic sectioning. This is the toolbar. So you can see if I cut on this plane, you can see it is completely hollow inside. But yes. Outside, right?
Outside.
Yeah. So outside it is closed. It is completely hollow inside. So we want to make the solid body using this command, using this complete thing. Okay, so how can we make the solid thing? Okay, so that for that we need to shift into the part design first. Okay, we'll go into start part design again, Okay, so now I am working on the solid body, right? So I will define the part body. So my operations, all the operations will be in a part body, okay? So I will select the part body and then I will on my surface-based features toolbar. So I right-click and surface-based features toolbar. So surfacing, we are closing the surfacing now. So surface-based features, this is a toolbar in the bottom, you can see. This is a surface-based features, okay? So click, you can see, this is my surface-based features. And the second command is your close surface, okay? So close surface means what? Like I want to close this surface and I want to make one close body, okay, solid body. So I will use the close surface command and I will select the join, final join that I'm selecting. Object to close, okay, object to close is that it's your join one, and click okay, okay. So now it is closed in the part body. You can see the closed surface has run. So we need just to hide this geometric set. So you can see my solid body is there. If you cut it, it will be completely solid.
Yes.
Right. Yeah. So this is procedure we are using in every product design thing. When you go for the surfacing things, you need to close your complete solid complete body in the surfacing, and then we are converting it into the solid thing. Okay, so this is things we are doing in the surfacing things. Okay, so this is just a minute. You are able to see my screen?
Yeah, I'm able to see, but it is like blank now.
Yeah, so we have seen the extrude, offset, fill, okay, blend, and multi-section. We will take again, okay, one time again, okay. So we have seen, okay. So more, there are commands in extrude also. There are three commands more. That is your revolve, sphere, and cylinder. Okay, so yeah, we'll find this. Okay. What is revolve command? So revolve is something like if you want to make the surface in the 360 degree, means circular manner. Yes. In addition, you can use the revolve command. Okay, if you have one curve, so I select on the plane this sketch. Okay, and I'm making the single line. Okay. That's it. Oh, just a minute. So now I have one single line here. Okay. So what I will do, I will use the this command revolve. So profile, I'm selecting line, and axis revolution, I'm selecting Z. Okay, so you can see the surface is created in the 360 degree from the curve. Okay, whatever, yes. Only one line. Okay, and if I close, if you want to close, I will give the angle that is 360 degree. Okay, so here angle two means like if you have one angle that is something like 180 degree, you want to give the second angle that is say like 90 degree. So both angles between 360 degree only. So 180 minus 90 is 270. So we are on one side of the curve, it is 180 degree, and from second angle, that is second angle, it is 90 degree. Okay. Like that, like this, you can use this command for revolving your surfaces in the 360 degree. Okay.
Okay.
So revolution axis and profile. Profile means this, and revolution axis means what will be your axis, okay, along that axis you can, yes, able to, yeah, so you can able to make the,
yes, revolution.
Yeah. Second is your sphere command. Okay, so sphere command we are using to complete a sphere. Okay, so if the input for sphere is required for one point, okay. So what I will do, I will use the sphere command. So it is asking for center. So I'm giving the center this. Okay.
Center.
Center means point. What I have created one point here, right? So center means I am giving the center point. So you can see the some things are created here. Okay. So it is asking this sphere axis. Sphere axis you can see x, y, z or create axis. It is taking absolute. Absolute means like there are three axes. Means like for sphere any axis will be same. Like same output we will get, right? So what is the the radius. So radius you can edit here. So if you want 30, you can add the 30. And the thing is like only two inputs we are required for this second command. Create this whole sphere. So if I click on the whole sphere, you can see the complete whole sphere is here. So inputs only required sphere radius and your point. But if you go with this create sphere by specifying the angles, so you can you want to specify these four angles. Okay, that is your parallel start angle. That is you can this one parallel start angle, parallel end angle. This parallel end, parallel start. Okay, so you can either directly edit from this also. Meridian means what? This angle. Okay, so meridian means this. You can control your angles in meridian. Okay, these four angles you can control. And how much you want you can create, and either again here radius you can edit. Okay, so here five inputs for first command, that is create the sphere by specifying the angles. You need radius and four angles, and in create the whole sphere only two inputs, radius and center. Okay, that is the thing. Okay, so if you want to create this type of profile, you can directly, if you see cut it, it is almost hollow from completely hollow from inside. Okay.
Inside.
Here also you can make if you want to make the thing. And finally it's your cylinder. Okay. So what is cylinder? So cylinder is like for cylinder we need again one point and one direction. Okay, direction of your cylinder. So if I click here, you can see point it is asking. So I'm selecting this point. And direction means like three direction you have. X, Y, Z, which direction you want, you can select right click. Like say like you want direction. So I will click the X direction. The cylinder will create in the X direction in the radius of 20, length 120 and length 220. Okay. Radius, you can put whatever you want. Length, you can put whatever you want in the length one and length. Okay. So here five inputs are there, point one, direction, radius, length one and length. And also if you want similar dimension at both sides, you can select the mirror extent. So whatever will be the length one, it will take automatically in the second time. Okay. So like you can change your direction also. If you want in Y, you can like Y, you can have Z, you can have Z. Whatever will be the direction you can say and point. Okay. Yeah. So this is like you can use the cylinder command. Okay. Yeah. So so these are the commands like in the extrude and revolution. Okay. So you can practice these commands also. So yeah. So yeah, today I think you can practice these commands. So tomorrow we'll take next commands. Okay. So these are the four and these two, six, seven. At whatever I have shown. So I will share with the video link also. You can see that in this session videos. Okay.
Okay.